सेकेंड वन,
इफ टू नेम्बर्स आर सेलेक्टेड randomly from 20 consecutive natural numbers natural numbers find the probability that the sum of the two numbers is first one an even number second one is an odd number So that means actually we have to select two numbers out of 20 natural numbers. That means that can be done 20C2 ways. Okay? But the probability that getting an even number, that must be. Even number means whenever you actually see odd plus odd even, even plus even is even. That means there are two choices. So that means out of 20 consecutive natural numbers, 10 numbers will be odd, 10 numbers are even. So that means selecting an even number is actually two numbers can be selected from 10 even numbers or two odd numbers can be selected from 10. That can be done in 10C2 plus 10C2 ways. Favorable cases will be 10C2 plus 10C2. So probability is 10C2 plus 10C2 by 20C2, okay? So let us write it first. Getting an odd number means not getting even number. So both are complementary events. So for example, this event is E, this is P of E bar. We know P of E bar is equal to 1 minus P of E. Okay, let us do it. So now, the number of ways of selecting two numbers from 20 is equal to 20C2, that is 19 by 2 into 1, so 190, that is 190. Let E be the event of selecting two numbers whose sum is even. Whose sum is even means the either it may be even plus even or odd plus odd. So that means here there are 10 even and 10 odd odd natural numbers. So now favorable cases for E, n of E is equal to either even or odd, that means 10 C2 plus 10 C2. So that means 2 into 10 C2, 2 into 10 into 9 by 2 into 1, this 2 gets cancelled, this will be 90. So now first problem, probability of even number, that means P of E, n of E by n of S. So 90 divided by 190, this is 9 by 19, 0, 0 gets cancelled. So now second one, so getting odd sum, P of odd, P of odd means P of E bar, that is 1 minus P of E. So 1 minus 9 by 19, okay, 19 minus 9 is 10, so 10 by 19, that's all answer. A problem in calculus, is given to two students A and B. Whose chances, of solving it, are 1/3 and 1/4. What is the probability that the problem will be solved if both of them try independently, this is the problem. So that means a problem is given to the two students to solve that problem. That problem should be cracked. So they are trying independently, separately they are doing the problem. So in order to get the answer, to get the solution, either A may solve the problem or B may solve the problem or both may solve the problem. So that means what we have to find out? P of A or B you have to find out. R means in the sense A union B. P of A union B you have to find out. Suppose if you say A be the event of solving by the solving the problem, B will be the actually event of solving the problem by B, then P of A union B you have to calculate. Independently means A comma B becomes independent events. Since A comma B are independent events, easily this problem we can solve. So I will explain, don't worry. Here what is given? So first, let A be the event of solving the problem by A. No problem, you can say E1 also. Let B be the event of solving the problem by the person B or by the student B. Here clearly given A comma B are independent events. Independent events, and given P of A is equal to 1/3 and P of B is equal to 1/4. So, problem should be cracked, problem should be solved. So, that means now what we have to find out means P of A union B. So, this we can write 1 minus P of A union B whole bar. So, this we can write 1 minus P of A bar intersection B bar. So, if A comma B are independent, by using multiplication theorem, P of A bar intersection B bar becomes 1 minus P of A bar into P of B bar. So, this we can write 1 minus P of A into 1 minus P of B. Just a substitution, that's all. So, now 1 minus 1 by 3 into 1 minus 1 by 4. So, 1 minus 2 by 3 into 3 by 4. 3 3 gets cancelled, 2 1 jar, 2 2 jar. So, 1 minus half, so 1 by 2. The probability of that, the problem will be solved is 1 by 2.